Hello everyone, welcome to Dr. Romesh's bird sanctuary. It's a beautiful sunny Sunday morning, and that sound is the alarm call of a noisy miner. And those are some noisy miners that are not alarmed by the alarm call. Today I'm going to try and do some more careful observation of the interaction of this mixed flock. So I'm going to try and follow a few individual birds. See what they do. It's quite difficult following birds that move as fast as noisy miners do. That's one of their sounds. That's a friendly sound. That's another sound that they make, the snapping of their beaks. And these are, of course, rainbow lorikeets. And I'm going to study their behavior too today. They have very complex behavior, very interesting behavior in the wild, which you don't get to see if you have them in cages. Including the way they hop on the ground. You see how the noisy miner makes way to the parrots, even though the noisy miners, you could say, have more claim to this territory, because they were here when I moved here 5 years ago. They're nesting in a tree at the back of the house. I don't know what made them all fly off just then. So interesting watching their interactions. Now this is one's come very close to me, a meter away. So I'll try and follow her. Or him, I can't quite be sure. She looks like a girl to me. This one's definitely a girl. sounds very close. The time it was the car that made them fly off. That one's a baby. The one at the back there. You could tell by the posture and the fact that they're fluff. The crest, the little bit of a crest that they have, the light green on the back of the head is a little bit elevated. Also, they don't have as long wing feathers. The head is more round. They also make a chee 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 sound, nasal sound. Now that bird over there, that's a blue-faced honeyeater. They're related to the noisy miners. There's a family of about five of them. There's two of them. Oh, the young ones, babies. That's one of the little toys that I make for them. It's a rotating perch. And when two birds land on it, it moves. In fact, even when one bird lands on it, it moves. And that's good practice for them. I'm trying to give them acrobatic abilities. You could say it's a bird gymnasium. Can they talk to each other? These are rainforest birds. That's why they're dressed the way they are. This one's what did they say? This is a male. You can tell because of the amount of red that's on its breast. You see how alert they are. Oh goodness me, that's nice. They're enjoying the perch. This is Dr. Romesh's bird gymnasium. parrot gymnasium. It's not just for the parrots, the noisy miners love that perch as well. That's where they can have a little political gathering. The alarm call's gone off. So they've taken up their defense positions. And the reason for the alarm call is this visitor. It's a male scrub turkey. Alectura lathami. Alectura lathami. Latham. He is called the father, or has been described as the father of Australian ornithology. And would you believe that Latham never came to Australia? He was a doctor, like myself. But he had dead birds shipped to him in England, where he described the specimen and named it. But he named it after himself, Alectura lathami. And this is a member of a family of birds called Megapodia, which means it has big feet. Now this one has one especially big foot, and that's his right foot. And if you look carefully, you can see that that foot has been broken. That's his left, that's his right. See, the right foot is broken and it's healed. Now that means that that bird has been through extraordinary privations, because breaking a leg for a scrub turkey is usually a fatal injury, because they can't run or walk. So this bird's a survivor. It also survived people who hunt scrub turkeys. Of course, the Aboriginal people used to eat scrub turkeys, and so did the white people. Except the Aboriginal people had woomeras and spears and boomerangs. The white people had guns. Now that bird is much more alarmed by the noisy miners than by myself. Yeah, you can see that he can run on his once broken leg. And these birds live in Tui Forest, which is about 500 meters away from where I am. That's a kookaburra. Let's see whether I can film the kookaburra. Of course, the scrub turkey running across the road, and the kookaburra flying off, being chased by a noisy miner. So if you want to come and visit me at Dr. Romesh's bird sanctuary, this is what it looks like from the road. I get onto the road. From the road it looks like this. And you can recognize it by the sound of happy birds. And you just walk down here. And if the birds like you, they will greet you. If they don't like you, they will issue an alarm call. That's what they'll do. These birds will issue an alarm call if they don't like you. If they do like you, they'll talk to you like that. They're not just talking to me, of course. They're talking to each other. I'm just party to the conversation. So, yeah. Welcome to Dr. Romesh's Bird Sanctuary, and come and visit me as long as you like birds. And don't bring a gun. Don't bring a taser. Don't even bring a boomerang. Okay. Thanks for watching my YouTube.